this is Chenchen. Welcome to my channel. I'm too lazy to put on makeup for the intro today, but if you want to make this cute little dress, you came to the right place. So let's get started. I got the pattern on Etsy. It's like $20-something. Great purchase. So the full name of this pattern is called 9015 Bombshell Bathing Suit Pattern Vintage Ruffle Skirt Swimsuit Play Suit Romper. So first, you want to lay your pattern on the fabric and just cut. Make sure you cut the little triangle there too, because that's how we use it to match the fabric later when we sew. And don't forget to copy all the lines from the pattern. Follow the lines and sew them on. Here is the top front. Place the back pieces of the top and match the little triangle. Sew along the edge. So that's how we connect the back to the front of the top. This is the cuff for the top. Fully rice it together and close the edges. Place the cuffs with top piece, match those little triangles and sew them on the top piece. Now here we are, our top is done. Now here's a little trick to finish the seams without an overlocker. Cut one side of the seam, leave about 2 millimeters. Fold the other side towards to the cut side and top stitch. Do the same to the seams on the top so that we have a nice and clean finish. Ta-da! Our top is complete. So excited. We could clip it on to give ourselves a vision of what the dress gonna look like. And if you are following this tutorial, we did nice job. So proud of us. Now let's continue the bottom. Make sure you draw this line on the right side of the fabric, because that's where we sew on the ruffles. Close the inseam of the short. Remember our little trick to finish the seam? Cut, fold, and sew. Remember, don't close the back of the short all the way up, because we need to leave space for the zipper in the end. I closed it and I had to open them later. And now we close the sides of the shorts. I'm doing this so slow, oh my god. By the time I finish, it's sunset already.
Tomorrow.
Okay, we're working on the ruffles today. Let me show you the pieces. We have 2 layers of ruffles. So we connect the pieces together. And this is what we get, a big donut. Next, we hem the edge for the donut. And this needs patience. Finally, we got 2 donuts to make the ruffle. So, here's what we do. We top stitch on the inner circle and gently pull the bottom thread, gently, because we don't want the thread break. Then, we are good to sew them on the shorts. Look at it, it's cute already. Oh, I'm so happy. Now we have the top, we have the bottom. We sew them together. By the way, if you're curious if I'm lonely here sewing all day, well, these are my cheerleaders, I mean my uncle's shop. They're all so beautiful, except this one. I don't know which kid did that to her, but she's a mess. The last step is to sew on the zipper. I did that off the camera because it took me too long to make it perfect. So, are you ready? Here's the final review. So first look, I paired a white shirt and a gray little tie, shoes are Converse, and I cut sleeves from an old top, made these leg warmers. I throw on a blazer and my little shoulder bag. It's cute, but I actually wish the blazer could be a little more oversized. Here's the second look, also my favorite one. It's September, it's chilling, and I love wear tights. A close-up look. The zipper put it on perfectly. Okay, the last look. I put it on this cute top, but I don't know what this type of collar called. Comment below, let me know. I also pair with the sheer tie and heels. I will make her twin sister in the next video. So thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye!